15 years back, I got an opportunity to visit Singapore. I was excited. I was very happy because this was my first journey abroad. When I saw Singapore, I could not believe roads were spick and span. I realized that maybe they had a stock Singapore. I could not find a single piece of paper or garbage anywhere on the road. Everyone was following traffic rules. No taxi was refusing, neither phone charging. When I inquired more, I found that per capita income of Singapore is 30 times compared to Indian per capita income. Everyone is educated. Women are soiled from the road. No corruption. Why the country is so rich and why we are so poor, I started comparing. When I dig into the history, I found even Singapore was ruled by British. We got independence in 1947, they got in 1957. Then why they reached that level? We have enough water. Singapore doesn't have enough water. We have to buy water from every country, Malaysia. We have vast resources of minerals. They don't have any minerals. We have enough land. Singapore doesn't have land. If they have to build an airport, they have to fill their sea. Then only they get some land. So what made them so rich and what made India so poor? This was a question haunting me. Back home, I asked few of my friends in India, why we are poor? Why Singapore is rich? When we share the same history, and came the great reply, we are overpopulated. Because of our population, we are poor. But I could not digest this answer. I searched and found there are many countries in the world which are more populated than India, but still they are very prosperous and very well developed. I mean density-wise. Density-wise, Holland, Japan, Taiwan, Hong Kong, and so many other countries are more populated than India. Still they are more prosperous and richer countries. It is not the reason, this is not the only reason that because we are overpopulated, that's why we are poor. Reason is something different, and I have to find that reason. When I search more, I talk to many people, I came to know the realities, why we are poor. And it was an eye-opener. I want to share that reason with all of you today. For this, I need to volunteers here on this place, please. Let us take the example of Raghu and Christopher. Raghu, let us assume, just assume, he is married, having one wife, two kids and one taxi. Two kids and one taxi, don't forget. He is very hard working. Instead of driving for 8 and 9 hours, he is working for 12 and 13 hours a day. And money does save, he is not wasting on himself, he is saving for the future. Over a period of time, he bought one more taxi. He is giving excellent service to his customers. And no wonder his business was growing by day and night. His two kids, who were studying in government schools, he transferred them to the best convent of the city. Over a period of time, they went to abroad for further studies. After their final studies, higher studies, they came back to India and joined multinational company at a very lucrative package. And he, during that 15 years, became a proud owner of a travel company with 20 vehicles in his name. This family is very much prosperous, happy, because of hard work of the family head. Because of the family head of this family is prosperous and doing good today. Now let us take the case of another, Christopher. He was also started from the same point. One wife, two kids, and one taxi. Everything remains the same, but Christopher was not very much interested in driving the vehicle. He was more interested in cricket. Not in playing cricket, but betting on cricket. Whenever there is a cricket match, he will park his vehicle and watch on television and put money on his favorite team. No wonder slowly he lost all his money. He lost his taxi also. He joined somewhere as a driver. The salary was not enough. He has to withdraw his both kids from the school and send them to nearby Dhaba for some extra income. They started working like child labor, and when they grew, they become normal adult labors. So friends, you have seen these two families which started from the same point, but because of different behavior, different work of the family head, one family prospered and other family become poorer day by day. Was that the fault of their children? Was that the fault of their children? No. Or was that the work of their family head?
That's right.
Similarly, as we have head of our families, in the similarly, we have head of our countries too. These head of countries are called by different names like king, queen, president and prime ministers. If this head of the country are working really hard, if they work with tenacity, if they work with blood, sweat and tears, then the country becomes developed and prosperous, and that country one day becomes like Singapore. And on the other hand, if the head of the country is selfish, corrupt, inefficient, then over a period of time the country becomes poorer and poorer and poorer, and the country becomes like India one day. Thank you. Friends, now question is, why Singapore elects honest leaders and why India ends up choosing a corrupt leader? And the answer is, we take voting and politics carefully. Voting day is one more holiday for us. We prefer to watch movies rather than going for voting. Many of us don't want to spend 1 hour. They don't want to spend 1 hour in that long queue. And it is rightly said, bad politicians are elected by good citizens. Bad politicians are elected by good citizens who don't vote. It is irony that for the bright future of our family, for the welfare of family, we visit temples, we visit religious places, we spare hours so that our family can prosper, but we can't spare 1 hour for voting. And in my opinion, the role of our king, role of our king is more important for the welfare of our family than role of our God. If our king is corrupt, if our king is inefficient, then even God will help us. Another thing, we love to hate politics. We think politics is something cheap, something useless, something inferior. Talented people will never go for politics. They will like to join IAS, IIT, IIM, and of course ISP. But they never hate politics. Because we treat politics and politicians as something cheap. We have to change our attitude towards politics and politicians. And we must realize that Gandhiji himself was a politician. It's a contradictory that on one side we hate politics and on the other side we worship Mahatma Gandhi, who was a politician. Because of politicians we got the freedom today. If we want to attract talent to politics, if we want the talented people to join politics, then we must start respecting politics and politicians. It's our duty. If you have to make India grow, then good people, honest people must join politics. We are member of Toastmaster International, where leaders are made. And it is our duty to spread the message that politics is not dirty. Politics is not cheap. It is the noblest way to serve your motherland. It is the best way to serve your country. The time you spend during that voting is not wasted of your time. This is the best time when you can write your destiny. Friends, Japan is great, Singapore is great, America is great. These countries are great only because these countries were ruled by great leaders. There is no other reason. If we elect good leaders, if we choose leaders who can work with blood, sweat and tears, then one day India will also become the best in the world. India can become best in the world, and the day will come when we can sing together proudly सारे जहां से अच्छा हिंदुस्तान हमारा, सारे जहां से अच्छा हिंदुस्तान हमारा।